Everybody, Ducky here. Today I have the final chapter NECA figure for Friday the 13th. Pretty happy about this one. I bought it used, but I just haven't been going to the stores lately at all. You know, I haven't been leaving the house like a lot of people. Been ordering stuff online. I found this one at a decent price for being used, and I went ahead and ordered it. So after this one, I think I'm missing, let's see, out of back there. So with this one, I think I'm missing now the there's a price sticker on there. Hey, look at that. I didn't know that included stuff like this. So you get the focus. Sculpture photography. That's funny. I think now that I'm gonna be missing the remake one and the Freddy vs. Jason. And after that, I think I have all the Friday the 13th ones. Well, not Friday the 13th. I think I have all the Jason Voorhees. Because I know there's like a NECA Friday the 13th accessory set. Camp Crystal Lake accessory set. And maybe I'll come across that one day. But let's go on the side of there. Check it out. Here is Jason out of the box. Looks pretty cool. I like how... it's pretty similar. I like that it's seems to be based off of. I mean, they do it with every one of these Jasons. I think I mention it every time, but like I like how it's never the same, like mold. Like it's not the same as part 3 mold where his shoulders are all hunched up and stuff. It actually like seems to resemble Ted White as Jason in that movie. It looks good. I like the how the clothes is like different from the part 3 one, if you guys can see it back there, but it's, you know, it's different, looks good, represents part 4 pretty well. So let's have a look at the mask. Looks good, nice and faded how it was in the movie, and just like all most of the other ones, his mask comes off, and there's that hideous face that's advertised on the box. It's pretty creepy. Has the axe mark from part 3, pretty cool, and looks pretty good, I like it. Just like a lot of the other NECA figures, it feels like quality, feels good, you know, it doesn't feel like it's gonna just come apart on me eventually. Feels pretty good. Not that I play with my NECA figures or anything, but, you know, it feels like it would last quite some time. Looks good. So. Let's have a look and see what all came with this adjacent. We also got a second head. This one looks like there's a... This one looks like there's a crack going all the way down. I don't know if that was like that before. But this one just looks a little more faded, this mask. And so for the head, it's at the end where he gets the machete on the side of his face. So it's pretty cool. And I like that they included a mask for it, because I guess they didn't really need to, just because at this point, the mask was cut off, but, looks cool, I like it, and I like that they included a mask, it's always cool. Looks good, like it. Alright, so weapons, we have the, I'm guessing it's like a bone saw. I'm guessing that's what it's called. I think the focus a little bit better. Let's see. But yeah, it's at the beginning when he gets taken to the morgue, and he takes out the overnight morgue guy with this thing. But yeah, it looks good. It's pretty good. There we go. It's a little bit better. All right. Then here's the machete. The weapon that takes him out in the end. Pretty bloody. Let's see what else we got. We have a double-sided axe. I don't remember him using this axe. So when I opened up the Roy Burns one some time ago, I couldn't remember for the life of me any of those weapons used that he came with, except for like the road flare. But just so like this one, I really can't remember when he used the double-sided axe in that movie. Maybe he just used it to take a couple doors down, because he was pretty destructive in that movie. He came with an extra hand, I'm guessing, to grip some of the weapons. And and yeah, it's pretty much what it is to grip stuff. There's the butcher's knife. This one I definitely remember. How they filmed it in reverse. It's a pretty cool scene when he gets what's his name, Jimmy. So here's the corkscrew for that. So the corkscrew comes into Jimmy's hand, and then as he looks down and then looks up, he gets the butcher's knife. It's pretty cool. Like that they included this corkscrew. That's probably like one of the coolest scenes in the whole series, when he's asking Teddy for the corkscrew and Jimmy gets it. Gets the corkscrew in his hand, and then the butcher's knife to his face. It was pretty cool. Alright, and then lastly, he for weapons, he got this kitchen knife. Looks good. Looks cool. Probably be putting pictures somewhere over here in this corner of when he uses the Whistle weapons. And then lastly, he came with the Pamela Voorhees tombstone. Nice. I think the dream version of Part 5 came with Jason Voorhees' tombstone. I know there's another tombstone that they've come with. And I think there's another Pamela one. I'm not sure. I'll have to look through them. But yeah, this one looks pretty cool. I like it. But yeah, I think this is a good one to pick up. Well, I like all the Jasons. Hopefully I'll come across the Freddy vs. Jason and the remake one at a decent price, and I'll order those. Because I'm pretty sure those are the last two I'm missing. But yeah. I think so far still my favorite one is the Part 3 Jason. And then Part 3. Well, it's the NES game, but he's pretty much like a mold of the Part 3 one. But I think those two so far are still my favorite NECA figures for Jason. But anyways, for you guys watching, how'd you like this NECA figure? Out of all the ones that have come out so far for the Friday the 13th ones, which one's your favorite? And as always, thanks for stopping by and hanging out, and I'll see you guys next time.